All right, we got our T5 here. We're gonna put this gear on first, change out our synchronizer, make sure we're the same. These little tabs right here have to fit on these dogs right there. Our gear slides on. And we got this little pin right here. This little dude got to go in this hole right here. And this is going to be a little bit difficult to try to do it on camera. Fits pretty tight in that hole anyway. And my fingers are a little fat to get down in there. Emma, slide in the hole. Okay. And we got this washer. The little pin's gonna sit in that. This is gonna face that way. Okay, then we got our bearing on the back. We gotta go press that on. We'll be back when that happens. Okay, like a dummy, I put this on upside down. So we gotta flip this around. Also got to flip the one around on the third gear. See if we can do this without having to take that all back apart. Come on, yeah. Can hold this all at one time. Come on, man. That good. Too far. Come on, baby. Let's go. Almost. Oh, come on. There we go. synchronizer. Make sure our old washer, where is it at? Is the same thickness. 81. 76, we're about 5 thousandths off. Let's see what our clearance comes out like. Alright, there's a little hole right here. This little tab fits into that. And we've got a snap ring. We want the short end of the taper of our snap rings up. Always. This one's a little bit hard to tell, but this is a little shorter up here. Little bit on the stiff side. There we go. Alright, then we got our gear, our synchronizer. These lines need to face up. Deep side down, shallow side up. Okay. Here we got these little pads. There's the knobs in there that go in these little cutouts right here. We got an O-ring back here. I got to change that. Don't think I, yeah, I did. As I said, I don't think I got one in the kit. I'm going to silicone this anyway, even though I got an O-ring. It always leaks out of here. Go. Synchronizer is going to go on top. I've already pressed the front bearing on. Make sure we're fitting good here. Now on the back here, I'm gonna have to put some grease. Oops. Take our bearing and our race out. And we have these roller bearings here. We have to stack those in here. All right, looks like we might have one too many rollers in the kit, which is fine. We just won't use it. They're fitting pretty snug. Let's try this other one. There we go. Alright, then we got our bearing here. Gonna fit in the back there. And our race. It's gonna sit on there just like that. Okay. And looks like they gave us a kit for a T4. Because we were missing a synchronizer. So, let me see what we're going to do about that. Customer supplied his own parts, so let's see what he wants to do about that. Be back. Okay, I've already done this. Press this in, flush. This little cap here is caved like that. It's just gonna sit in there. I put some sealer around it and it'll just fall in. And then you just take, I just took this and flattened it out. When it flattens out, it spreads out and it'll seal up in there. I went ahead and put some sealer to make sure everything's okay. Inside here, you get two different washers. You want the washer that's gonna fit around your bearing and that little tab right there. It's gonna fit right there. Our countershaft is gonna go in. Bearing's gonna go on the back. Just a little too far. We'll get that straightened out. Put our rod in. There's a slot right here. This is gonna go. Turn that. Okay. Alright, I already depressed our speedometer gear on the back. Our speedometer gear, our fifth gear. Get our synchronizer on there. Got a cutout here that's going to face down at the counter shaft. There we go. Alright, on our bearing retainer here, the shims that were in there measured 36 thousandths, so that's what I'm going to start off with. Not going to put any silicone on here yet until we make sure that we are all good to go. Lube up my seal. And put two bolts in the bearing retainer. What I really need to do is put this in a hole in the table. Then my camera's not going to be right. So I'm just going to explain what I'm going to do. I'm going to put my race back here. I'm going to put my tail housing on. And I'm going to check my in play. And once I do all that, then I'll come back. Now, my shim was wrong on the housing here. It was too loose. I had to add another, I think it was 11 thousandths, 12 thousandths. We're at 48 thousandths. Now we were at 36. And that came out right. So, throw this stuff away. Can't need our shims anymore. And on fifth gear back here. Got our synchronizer. So we make sure it fit. That. We got more pads on this fork. Okay. Don't need these. Throw that stuff away. See if we can get somewhat of a view. I'm going to go ahead and put silicone around here. Make sure we don't leak out of there. And I'm going to go ahead and put some on here, even though I did put sealer on it. You don't need a big gob of silicone on here. A thin layer is just fine. It's going to just squeeze it all out anyway. Put your drain hole at the bottom. Millimeters. I have to look up the torque specs on this, but I bet you we're around 18 to 24. Okay, well, it doesn't really say. Tail housing is 20, so we're a little bit smaller than those. I'm going to drop it down to about 15. Came out. Get back in there. There we go. Okay. Now when we put this down in there, not only are these going to have to line up with the shaft here, we're going to have to slide this over this way. Our forks are going to have to line up in here, and when we slide back in, This is going to have to slide into here. So put a thin layer of silicone here. Two of these bolts have a shoulder on them. There's another one like that. The rest are like this. The two shoulder bolts, one goes there, one goes there. Getting ahead of myself talking about stuff. Up there. I didn't have the one pad in there correctly. We moved off. Come on now. Maybe we're a little too far back. There we go. These are 9 foot-pounds. I guess I should have put my bearing in the back, but we can do that in a second. Forgot I'd taken it back out because we had to take it back apart, or I had to take it back apart. I'll torque it down in a moment. Go ahead and put this back in. Correctly. So once I get that corrected, I'll be back. I'm just wasting camera time. Okay, this snap ring, short end of the taper goes up. Okay, come on. Oh, dang, my ankle's giving out. What's up with that here lately? It's been doing that, just all of a sudden it'll give out. Every day, something else gives out. I'm on now. Being the most difficult. Yeah, I'm hung up on that little ledge right there. Here we go. Alright, snap rings on. We have a little shim, goes right there. Our gear goes on. Probably, yep, it went, so we don't have to worry about that. We got our synchronizer up in here. Our forecast to go on the shaft at the same time. Turn a little bit. It looks good. New roll pin goes in here. That's hurting a little bit. Let's get get something to brace against that. Turn again. Well, it keeps turning on me. Back here and snap ring short end of the taper up. And I'm gonna get down in the hose. Okay. Lay this down. Here we go, putting a towel housing on. See if we can get all of our gears without dropping our rod again. Okay, I think it over-traveled. Great. So let me straighten this out. I'll be back. Okay. Got this plastic piece. It's gonna go on the back of the shaft there. Silicone around the O-ring here. So got that. Silicone around here, you don't need a lot. Oh, I gotta find me a rear seal. I forgot all about that. Since they bought a two-wheel drive kit, mine is a 4x4. It did not come with the seal. So I'm gonna have to make this quick. I thought it was the same as an automatic, but it's not. So I have to put the seal in afterwards. 15 millimeters. One 13 millimeter goes up here. Said 20 foot-pounds on the torque, but it seems a little low. That's what it says. I'm wondering if this I bet you this extension housing seal is the same as the older 4x4, since this is kind of older. The one I have is the newer. I think I got one of them old ones laying around here somewhere. Down in here, here's little detents right there. We're gonna stick the ball right on there. The spring is gonna go up inside of here. This is going to go in to the shaft, and the roll pin is going to go through right there into right there. And then once we get this into there, we put the shifter on it and make sure we got all of our gears. So you're not going to be able to see that. I'll be back when I get that done. All right, put some grease down in there too to help lube it up until oil gets thrown up into there. Eventually we'll get oil up into there. And there's a little hole down in here, right in here, that drains back. So we'll check this, make sure we got all of our gears. Here's first. Make sure we go back to neutral. That's neutral. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth. And reverse. Alright. Make sure we're back. And we are back in neutral. Alright, just got to find me the rear seal. And this one's ready to go. See you on the transfer case rebuild if we get those parts.